do you like the challenge of guys like Russell Westbrook?
Definitely. You know, Oklahoma is one of the best teams, you know, one of the best teams in the NBA. And Westbrook was one of the best guards. You know, he's playing great this year. And so it was a great challenge for me and very happy, you know, with the victory and, you know, the team effort. You know, everybody played great last night.
You had another double-double with 10 assists. There was one assist in particular that sort of struck me. It was a two-on-one with George. And you sort of drew both defenders over to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was gonna go, you know, for my teardrop, and I saw Durant come and I saw George, you know, open, so I passed it to him. And you know, that's what I've been doing this year a little bit. You know, sometimes, you know, I could have taken the shot, but try to get some easy baskets, you know, for my teammates, and George was open.
How comfortable are you and RJ with the alley-oop now? It seems like you get one of those every other game or so nowadays.
Yeah, we have to stop talking about it. I tell people, you know. Every time they put it on the NBA highlights, I'm like, stop putting it, you know.
There have been a few teams, it seems like, that seem to know the action. They're getting a guy to kind of go with it.
Yeah, it depends, you know. That's a type of play, you know, you don't want to use it too much, you know. We only do it like once, maybe every two games, you know. We don't want to use it all the time because then we don't want the other teams, you know, to be able to read it.
What's the sense going off on this three-game trip? Just keep it going, keep playing the way?
Yeah, keep it going. I think the main thing for us now is like not be satisfied, you know, and keep pushing and take pride, you know, on our defense. You know, our defense was great last night, and we need to use those games as example, you know, the Laker game and this game, and, you know, build from that. And, yeah, like I said, you know, can't be satisfied. I think that's going to be the main thing for us going forward, is to, you know, battle ourselves a little bit. But, you know, I'm not worried about those next two games. You know, it's still big games. You know, New York is playing great. Boston is playing great. So I'm not worried about us, you know, not bringing the energy or not being motivated.
Amari was such a big part of the Spurs-Suns rivalry.
Yeah.
What's it been like to see him go to New York and play the way he's been playing?
I'm happy for him. You know, he's playing great. And I think for the NBA, it's great to have the Knicks, you know, at that level and, you know, put some excitement, you know, in the league. And I'm just happy for everybody over there.
Yeah,
and
for Spike Lee?
Yeah, definitely. And so I'm just happy. I think it's great for basketball.
Looking forward to the challenge this three-game road trip's going to give you all?
Yeah, you know, we always play great on the road, and I think it's going to be a great test for us the next three games.
How hard is it for you guys when you face a team like New York, which is so up-tempo, score a lot of points, and the very next night you got defense?
Yeah, we're used to it. You know, every night, you know, it's a different challenge and different matchups, and, you know, New York is a little bit of the Phoenix of the East, you know, so, well, we're used to that.
That might be the best question from one of you shooters all year. That was a good one, Jack.
Thank you. Start off the new year right.
You guys play so well. What's the weakest link of the team this year?
Well, I think we got a lot of stuff we can improve. You know, you always have room for improvement. Obviously, our defense had a lot of improvement to make. And I think lately, you know, we've been doing good. It's a little bit of everything. Our plays, execution, the way we run stuff. I think we can always improve.
When you guys broke that huddle, did you guys say defense?
We always say defense. Yeah.
Can you tell me why?
I don't know. It's been like that since I've been here. So I don't know who started it. I'm sure Pop started it. I had no choice when I was 19. You know, I had to say whatever they were saying.